Welcome to another video. In this video, we're learning how we can read from Notion databases. All the code that we have now has been written in our previous three tutorials where we learn how to authenticate, write, and read from into Notion databases. So if you haven't checked those out, definitely do so. Let's get started. I'm gonna set the 5-minute timer and jump right in. First things first, let's create a database. We're gonna create an inline database and we're gonna call this website analytics. Great. Let's change the rows a little bit, or the columns. We'll call this user ID. We'll call this event, and then we'll change the type to a select field. And we'll add one more date column. And we'll just call that date. That's perfect. All right, so let's add a couple rows. I'm gonna use my handy bash UUID function here to add a couple IDs. You would think that when these events come in, they'll come in as UUIDs. We're going to create a visitor event and a sign up event, and we're just going to put some dates in here. So whatever shows up is great. And then we're going to delete this last row. Excellent. So next thing you need to do is get your Notion database ID. So we're going to come in and copy the link. We're going to create a new variable, Notion database ID equals. And when you paste this link, your ID is going to be the first UUID after the slash. So we're going to grab that and jump into our code. So first thing we want to do is read the information from our database. So let's go ahead and do that. We'll call this dbinfo equals client.databases.retrieve. Excellent, yeah. So GitHub Copilot knows exactly what we want here. If you're not using GitHub Copilot, definitely hop on the AI train. It is here, it's here to stay. Engineers using it are going to be better off. Let's write to, we'll reuse our write dict to file as JSON function. And let's go ahead and see the output of this function. So let's check out our dbinfo.json. Let's prettify this. And as you can see, we have all the information from our website analytics minus our actual rows. So this is just giving metadata about the database itself. So let's go ahead and learn how to read the rows. The first thing we need is a function that will help us safely get nested properties from complex objects. So I'm just gonna paste this function in. This will be, you know, all the code, all the information you need to get this running will be in the description. But basically this allows us to run functions like this to get information out. All right, so let's go ahead and get our rows. DB rows, perfect, equals client databases query. And now that we have our rows, we can write our rows to a dictionary. And now we're going to loop through our rows for row in DB rows results. Let's get rid of the prints. Let's get rid of the ID. We want our user ID. We want our event. And then let's create one more. We want our date, right? We will put these all in a list. We'll call these simple rows. It will append all these items. And then after we do this, we're going to dump out our simple rows to a JSON file. We're going to comment this code up for now so that we can see the structure of the database row. So let's go ahead and run this and look at DB rows format. And as you can see, we have this results key value pair that's an array, which contains properties. In each one of these properties, we have a nested selection of keys that we need to access, which is why we imported that safe get method. So let's go ahead and run properties.event select.name. This is how we're going to obtain our event. So let's go ahead and uncomment this code and repeat for each type. So let's go ahead and paste that in. So that's how we get our event. And let's go ahead and continue. We're running out of time here. So it's going to be properties. .date.date.start. Let's paste that in our date. One more. Let's run properties.userid.title.0.plaintext. Just as we're running out of time, let's go ahead and paste that in. And let's run and see what we get. All right. So let's look at our simple rows.json file that was created. Let's pretty print. And as you can see, guys, we have our rows as JSON. So as you can see, each row aligns with a row in our database. Thanks so much for tuning in. I hope this video was helpful. If I went too fast, feel free to stop at any point. All the code, all the links are going to be in the description. We just learned how to read from Notion databases in 5 minutes. So I'll see you guys in the next video where we learn how to write to Notion databases. Peace.